In a perfect world, you're going to have a builder and an architect begin the project. And really, that first 8 weeks, right, that exploratory stage with the customer. As many of you know, we always have designers on every project. We have architects and predominantly landscape architects, right? That's one of the other components. I mean, really, there's the big three: builder, architect, designer, but also landscape architecture. And that really is important depending on where you build. HOAs, here we're in the desert, so desert is really important to have a good landscape architect. A lot of that's driven by, we work in natural area open space, NAOS. So landscape architect is going to assist us with making sure any of the natural vegetation is relocated. And anyways, we'll do another video as far as landscape architect, but really, how does that integration work? If you're the builder and you're first on the project, or you're the architect, either way, in a perfect world, you're gonna have a builder and an architect begin the project. And really, that first 8 weeks, right, that exploratory stage with the customer, is when you sit down and you understand what's their aesthetic, what's their design, what's the qualifications of the house, how many square feet will the house be, how many bedrooms, how many bathrooms, you know, what's their living condition. And you start asking these questions to understand the day-to-day of each of the clients. Now, the designer in a perfect world is already integrated. They're hired and you have the team together from day one as you start going through the floor plan. Now, in some cases, that may not be the case. It may just be the architect or the builder or both. But at any rate, you know, as that team starts that first 8 weeks and you're working on floor plan, you're working on configuration and layout of the lot, that's really important when you have to bring the designer into the process. Once you have that floor plan done, before you move to the next step, before you move to elevations, ceiling heights, and of course structural, mechanical, right, all the professional side, that is when the designer should be integrated into the project. My opinion is that when the designer comes in at that phase, now they can look at the project and, you know, they have amazing advice. They'll say, look, we need to relocate the water closet. I don't want to open the powder bath door and see the water closet. They'll start having an understanding of furniture and layout and the design of the client so they can make recommendations on flow, on layout, on cabinetry, you know, the working triangle in the kitchen for the client, multi-sliders, I mean, fire pits, fireplace. I mean, all these little things come into play where the designer can now give their opinion on layout. And now what ends up happening is in that first 8 weeks, you know, you have the input of the builder from a cost perspective, right? As we're looking at that cost and things that will increase and decrease the budget. We have the designer helping us with layout, making sure everything's gonna flow. And then you have the architect that's the expertise from the building envelope. Now, this is really important because really what it comes down to is a successful project. If you can get all three involved in that first 8 weeks, now you have everyone on the same page. It's going to eliminate changes. So for us as the builder, the advantage is during frame stage, I don't have to walk a client through and reframe essentially the entire house or change windows or change the layout in a bathroom or master suite because that's already been done. The designers looked at it. They've given their stamp of approval after the changes have been done. And now that saves me on build time. It saves me on aggravation and cost. You know, where the client may say, why is this a change order? This is easy. And you get into that dispute of cost. It eliminates all that by having that at the beginning. And then the key is once the design is figured out from a floor plan perspective, well, now again, now it's really important that you have the designer with the architect because you have to start figuring out the building height, the ceiling heights, the exterior envelope, you know what the elevations look like, and this will impact the ceiling designs, the ceiling treatments from the designer, and now everyone's on the same page as they start looking at the overall design. And once you have the floor plan, the elevations, and the ceiling heights, you know, the roof line, that's it. That's our first phase. That's really key. And then we divide into two areas. And this is where it's really important because you have the architect now that can run with the floor plan, the elevation, the ceiling heights, and he can start working on, or she can start working on the structural, mechanical, grading and drainage, civil, you know, that component, while at the same time the interior designer is now working on finishes and selections and layout and cabinetry. And these two things are happening simultaneous, you know, and we're still having constant meetings every month, every couple weeks, we're meeting to make sure everything the designer is doing is shown and replicated with the architectural plans. especially in regard to lighting layout and electrical, which is really key.